the director of Petta, Mr. Karthik Subbaraj, sir. One of the most challenging aspects is to direct Rajinikanth, sir. Is that how you feel?
It's not a challenge, it's actually pleasure, and right word is like it's not something that's going to that's so easy to happen. So it's a pleasure, it's not a challenge.
How long did you try to attempt to make a film that can actually star cast Rajinikanth in it?
As I said, like first time Rajini sir, when I met him, he's the one who gave me confidence as such that yeah, I could even pitch a story to Rajini sir. And then came, I pitched the story, and it was like 3 years back. So it actually took 3 years for Rajini sir to, for things to fall in place.
Many have actually told me that, you know, you were actually directing the movie as a fan of Rajinikanth himself. So how big a fan are you of Rajinikanth? Because we see traces of the 70s and the 80s Rajini in this film.
Yeah, of course. I'm a very ardent fan of Rajini sir right from my childhood. So I grew up watching his film. As I said, for me, I think the main reason why I got fantasized by film as such is Rajini sir. Like, because that's the first time I got attracted to the larger than life of cinema. So not only me, the entire team were like a bunch of Rajini fans directing, working with him. So we all directed a film, made the film like that.
I mean, knowing his age as well as his health constraints, was it a bit of a challenge in terms of, you know, the different locations that you chose while shooting the film?
So both the things, no? Both, whatever you said, age and health constraint is a lie. And you will know like in the film when you see him. And even the spot when you see him, he's in a different energy level, and age is just a number for him. I mean, he's, you would not even believe like he's 65 plus in this film. He's not done a 65 plus.
What is that one memorable scene from the film that will always remain etched in your mind?
Everything is memorable. Every day is memorable. But I would say like the first shot which I shot for this film, I wanted it to be memorable for me, not for like Rajini sir, because for me, like, it is something that's happening in my life. I wanted it to be a memorable shot. So I was thinking, like, what should I do? Then I suddenly got this idea of like, because Rajini sir's first shot, it was Saburu Ragangal's opening the gate. So that's the first shot I shot for this film. So that I will remember always, yeah.
Is there a specific reason why the character is named Kali? Is it only because of Mullum Malarum?
Yeah, it's a tribute to that character, because that's a character which I love the most and which has inspired me a lot, and as a performer that character is awesome.
In this particular film we see him as, you know, guarding the hostel. He comes as a hostel warden. Would you also like to see him as, you know, a politician guarding the state of Tamil Nadu?
In real life, of course. Okay. I'm looking forward for that, yeah.
Also, there is always this, you know, specification or an interest or a wish that all these Kannadigas have that, you know, Rajinikanth must also do a Kannada cinema. The you know, smallest distance that they could come to is Rajinikanth dubbing in Kannada. Will that happen or not for this film?
I think Sun Pictures, Jack Manchu sir, along with Sun Pictures, they are going to try for that. It will be great if it happens, yeah.
There's also a controversy with respect to the dubbing in Kannada cinema. Many of them, you know, who are averse to it. So will that kind of pose to be a problem? Is that why Petta has been avoided being dubbed in Kannada, conveniently putting the blame on Rajinikanth?
I don't know about that. because I have been in Bengaluru for 5 years, and I have seen a lot of films here. And I don't see sort of any aversion here, because I think here people, audience, everybody, they all love film and they always support good content. I think there shouldn't be a problem.
My final question to you. So right now, has Rajinikanth seen the entire, you know, film of Petta? What was his first reaction when he saw the, you know, film?
He has seen the, not the final version, but the previous version. So he's seen it and he loved it. He loved it and he really enjoyed it. And
will this be like a political launch pad?
No, it has nothing to do with politics. It is just, to bring back the Rajinism. I mean, it's not like bringing back, but celebrating Rajinism, that's what I would say.
all the best to you. Thank and we hope that, you know, all of them will get Rajinified like yes. you've mentioned in the trailer.
Yeah,
thank you so much for that. So that was Mr. Karthik Subbaraj, who's also an ardent fan of Rajinikanth, and he has directed this particular movie. It took almost 3 years for him to, you know, make his dream come a reality today. So let's all wish Petta happens to be a success or not, will still remain a question mark. But for now, that was Karthik Subbaraj with video journalist Abubakar Pratibha Raman for My Nation.